You ever seen somebody lose a fight and talk like they won? That's my dad. Like, after he got knocked out, he's like, you good? Are you good now? I said, Dad, I don't think that's your lines. I think the winners say that. I think the guy who won say that. You just lay down for a second and let him finish his speech. I think you got up too fast anyway. You're going to be dizzy. When I saw my dad get knocked out, and I saw my brother get knocked out, you know what it made me think? It made me feel like, as a family, we're not good at this particular activity. We're not fighters. We're readers. We're good readers in my family. See, here's why I don't fight, man, because you don't know what people are capable of now. Too many people know too many different things. I'm serious. You know what I'm scared of? UFC fighters. You know why? Because they're real. It is not a game, people. They are here. They exist. They know shit. Touch a pressure point, shut your whole body down. Bow. It's a wrap. All right. Can't move none of that. Fight back. I can't. Everything is shut down. I don't know what it did. Everything. I can't move anything. You don't gonna be the ones that get their asses whipped by these guys? Thugs. I'm gonna tell you why, because thugs, y'all don't know how to just fight, man. Thugs always gotta give you a speech before they fight. You ever see how long it take a thug to fight? He gotta give you his whole background before he fight. It take too long. Yeah, real niggas, all day. Just me, by myself, on the block, holding it down, gun in my waist, straight face, all day, not a game, in jail, by myself. One bed, no pillowcase, one pillow. Didn't nobody write me. It was early. Woke up, went back to sleep, took a nap. You ever go night-night, nigga? You ever go night-night, nigga? Everybody go night-night, nigga.
What? What does this have to do with the fight? Are we fighting or not?
You didn't write me.
I don't know you.
These guys are going to be the ones, man. Everybody can't be a thug. Everybody cannot be a thug, man. I can't stand TV thugs. You know what a TV thug is? Those guys do what they see on TV. All day, every day. All day, every day. You ever see those guys? Yeah, nigga, what, nigga, what? You ever see the... Never seen the dancing thugs get out the car? Nigga, what? Nigga, what? Nigga, it ain't a game. Think it's a game around here? That ain't no game. I don't like those guys. I know real thugs. My uncle is a real thug. Certified. Put a stamp on him. Locked up 15 years, got out of jail, ain't nothing changed. Very serious. Like, listen, when my uncle talk, this how he look. I don't care what he talking about, this how he look. I don't care what he's saying. Put the goddamn jelly on the motherfucking sandwich. Do it, spread it. He's crazy. He's crazy. He's institutionalized, man. You gotta understand, when you've been in jail for 15 years, all you know is jail. Your mannerisms, your language, you eat, sleep, and think jail, okay? Your threats aren't even the same. Like, whenever you threaten somebody, they should know what's about to happen. It's a transition into a fight. I'm sick of your ass. Get up. When they get up, they know it's gonna be a fight. Stuff my uncle says leaves you in suspense. They're like the worst jail metaphors I've ever heard in my life. I don't even know how to explain them, okay? He gets out of jail. My brother called me. He said, Kev, Uncle Richard Jr. just got home. I said, what? I'm on the first flight. I'll be there in the morning. I ain't seen him in 15 years. I gotta see him. I get there, my uncle in the middle of the living room floor. I'm hyped to see him. I'm like, Uncle Richard Jr., what up, baby? 15 years, that's a long time, man. How you been? I swear to God, that's what he said to me. Say it with your chest, little ass nigga. I didn't know what to say. My brother came out of nowhere and grabbed me. He was like, chill. He was saying this all day. We don't know what it means. Just wait a minute till we figure it out. Now, here's the thing, right? I said, no, I'm not going to chill. I'm going to talk to him. Y'all not talking to him. I pulled him to the side and said, look, a lot of stuff has changed since you've been going, man. I'm doing well. I'm making good money now. Let me take you out, put you around some women, get some drinks. We'll have a good time. He said, all right, cool. I take him to a lounge, right? I'm at the bar. I'm drinking. There's women around me. I'm having a good time. I can't see him, but I can hear him. I can't see him, but I can hear him. Out of nowhere, all I hear is, I'm sick of this motherfucker, man. Kev, pin the tail on his ass. Is it his birthday? Why would I do that? Why would I do that? What do you mean? Peel this motherfucker's muffin cap back blue.